Regarding of prayer, you will be fruitful. I say you will multiply. I say you will increase. You will wax strong. You will wax great. In the name of Jesus.
Join us every Sunday, 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. at Princess Margaret Road, East Tilbury, Essex, RM18 8SB. Tap into the anointing.
We give you all the glory. We give you all. We give you all the glory. We give you all. Amen. Ancient of Days, we give you all the glory. I am that I am, we give you all the glory. Lord, we give you all the honor. The hour has come to glorify yourself, O Lord. Let the world come with fire. Let it come with power. Let it come with grace. Let it come to bless. Let it come to correct. Lord, at the end of this one, take all the glory. Release the blessing, O Lord. I come against every false spirit. I come against the spirit of buying and selling. I plead the blood of Jesus. Holy Spirit, add your way. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Jehovah. We give you all the glory. For in Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed. Can somebody celebrate Jesus? I didn't say celebrate me. I said celebrate Jesus. I can only hear elders. I just celebrate Jesus.
Let's open our Bible to the book of Philippians chapter 2. I'll read verses 1 to 11 for us. Philippians chapter 2. Verses 1 to 11. Philippians chapter 2. If you are there, say amen. If you are not there, say, wait for me. So I believe everybody is there. And I'll read the word of God for you. If there be therefore any consolation in Christ, if any comfort of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any prayers and mercy, fulfill ye my love, that ye be like-minded, having the same love, being of one accord, of one mind. Let nothing be done through strife or vain glory, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem other better than himself. Look not every man on his own thing, but every man also on the things of others. Mark verse 5. Let the mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men, and being found in fashion as a man, he humbled. Let somebody say humble. That's what we say, humble. He humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore, highly exalted him,
and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee shall bow, of things in heaven and of things in heart, and things under the heart, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. May the Lord bless the reading of his holy word in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bless the reading of his holy word in the name of Jesus. The title of my message, because it's a month of transformation, you will be transformed. I say you will be transformed in the name of Jesus. This is our month of transformation. Amen. The title of my message is The Mind of Christ. What do I say?
Mind of Christ.
Again?
Mind of Christ.
I want you to repeat. What do I say?
Mind of Christ.
Again?
Mind of Christ.
Again?
Mind of Christ.
The mind of Christ. The mind of Christ. What about the mind of Christ? What are we talking when we say the mind of Christ? Philippians chapter 2 verse 5 says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. This month we want to probe what is in the mind of our Lord Jesus Christ. We don't only want to probe, but we want to emulate it, and we want to behave like Christ. Because the reason why they we are called Christians is because they saw them behaving like Christ. But these days, you cannot differentiate a Christian and a non-Christian. Yes, in those days when we were young, when you see an SU, you know those SU, nobody, they don't need to tell you that this one. But today, you cannot differentiate. But the Bible says there must be difference between those people that serve God and those that serve Him. God will consecrate you. You shall separate, you shall be separated from the world. In the name of Jesus, I said you will be single out. You cannot differentiate, because people in the job, they talk the way the people in outside, they talk, they dress the same way. The thing that you see in the world, people bring it to church. So, the devil said, even the people in the world said, if you even come with the gospel, say, which gospel are you preaching? Your people, they talk the way we talk. They dance the way we dance. Everything that we do outside there, you do it. So what makes you to be a Christian? You will be differentiated today in the name of Jesus. You see, this Bible is a book of instruction. What do I say? It's a book of it is being inspired by God. Those prophets that wrote it down, it is God that inspired them. This is the will of God for us. Hallelujah. Point number two. Christians, we are not supposed to live anyhow. What do I say? Talk to me, George. I want to respond. We are not supposed to live. We are not supposed to live anyhow. Sir, when you join a military force, thank God there is a retired military man here. You go for training. A military man does not behave the way an ordinary person behaves. A military man, when you see a military man in their schedule, the way they do things, you will know they are trained. And when the Lord has drafted you, the Bible says, brought you out of darkness into its marvelous house, light. The Lord did not bring you to come and bring that pollution. He brought you to be washed by the word, to be washed continually, to be transformed. That is why the scripture says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. I pray there will be transformation this month. I say you will be transformed this month in the name of Jesus. Do you know that is why Jesus Christ, when Jesus Christ, he met that man in the book of John 3. He was a scribe or Pharisee's brother. He said,
except a man is born again. He cannot see the kingdom of God. Except a man is born of spirit and of water, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. I pray for transformation for you. I pray for transformation for you. In the name of Jesus, there must be transformation in the way we live. Hallelujah. We must behave differently from where we are coming from. Do you know some relationships will have been saved? Some souls will have been saved. Some marriages will have been saved. Some friendship will have, you know, some union will have been saved if we behave as it's been described by the word of God. But because there is no transformation, because the people, some people are just coming to church, you will never go the same way.
Yeah.
Oh, you are not here. What is wrong today? I said you will never go the same way.
Yeah.
It is futile when you come and you go the same way. There's nothing, no imperfection. It's effort in futility. I said you will be fruitful.
Yeah.
I said you will be fruitful.
Yeah.
When you come and you drink of what is there and you eat, we are supposed to be transformed. But because of the things we go through in the world, we just go, let me just come and show face. That will never be your portion in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I said there will be newness.
Yeah.
There will be changes,
yeah,
in your way of life. Oh, I pray for somebody today. The hand of the Lord will be upon you.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. So what are we saying? Let this mind be in you. What mind are we talking about? What is in the mind of Jesus Christ? What mind do you want me to be, to practice? What things are you talking about? Hallelujah.
Yes.
The Bible says, he being God, he made himself of no reputation. He didn't make himself of no reputation. Do you know if you are to be yourself or myself that took on the fashion of a man being God? And then when people greet him, you say, don't you know who you are greeting? Don't you know I am Mr. God? You are greeting me like that? I had a story of somebody say a whole me, human being, dust, ordinary dust. Mr. Hold me die, he couldn't get up. Somebody say, Mr. Hold me die, he say he can never die. They say, Mr. Hold, he can never die. That man, because of spirit of pride. Hallelujah. In fact, they did not know Jesus Christ among the disciples. Judas has to say, it is the one that I kiss, that is the one. They don't know him among the disciples. But if it were to be you or me, say, I am the Hallelujah. The Bible says he made himself of no reputation. He became a servant in the likeness of man. Verse 8, the Bible says he humbled himself. Point number one. He humbled. What did he do? That is the mind that the Bible is talking about. He humbled himself. He did not exalt himself. He did not raise himself. He did not say, do you know I am God? Do you know? He asked Peter, who do men say, some call you Elijah, some call you Elijah? He said, who do you think I am? Said, thou art Christ, the only Son of God. He says, flesh and blood has not revealed it. But my Father in heaven, there will be revelation.
Amen.
There will be power.
Amen.
There will be glory.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death. Verses 9 and 10. Do you know there's reward for obedience? The Bible says, wherefore God has highly exalted him, that at the name of Jesus Christ, every knee shall bow, of things on earth and of things below, and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is God, to the glory of God the Father. The Bible says he humbled himself. We are talking about humility. That is what is in the mind of God. That is what God wants us to be like. We are talking about being humble. We are talking about humane spirits. Humane spirits. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. He made himself of no reputation. Hallelujah. Something happened now in the book of Matthew chapter 3. Matthew chapter 3, verses 13 and 14. When you read John chapter 1, verse 3, he said there was nothing that was made without Jesus Christ. That is, anything that was created by God the Father was orchestrated by Jesus Christ. He said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among men. And the Bible said, there was nothing that was made without Jesus Christ. And the one that made John the Baptist came to Jordan. And when John the Baptist saw him, he said, no, I am not to baptize you. You are the one. He said, no. He said, suffer it to be so, so that the scripture will be fulfilled. Do you know if it were to be you or me? I created you now. So you want to deep me what I mean? I am the one that created you. I am Mr. Jesus. I am God. I am the Son of God. I created you. But he said, no. He humbled himself. John the Baptist, the one that he created, he did Jesus Christ in water and brought Jesus back. Another thing happened in the book of John, chapter 13. He wanted to show them an example. He said, bring water. All their messy water, all their messy legs, the one that they are in the mud. He said, bring it. He washed it and he used it to it. Peter said, no. Master, you are not. He said, if I don't wash you, you don't have part in me. You have part in Jesus Christ. Yeah. And when he finished, you know what he said? He said, I have just given you an example. See that you yourself, you do it to others. I pray that the Spirit of Jesus Christ will come over us in the name of Jesus. What is the opposite of humility? What is the opposite of to be humble? Pride. What do I say?
Pride.
What do I say?
Pride.
Do you know some people say, if not because of me, have you heard that statement before? If not because of me, they will not eat in that house. If not because of me, you know, the school fees will not be paid. If not because of me, he will not get his paper. Some people, they turn themselves to mini God. What does I say? Mini God. There's a song in our language. I can't sing it because we are multinational. He said, if not because of me, my friend cannot eat. If not because of me, my friend cannot pray. He said, please don't say that. It is God that can say and do it. You are just an instrument. God, when God uses you to help somebody, believe it or not, you are just an instrument. Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 20, he said, you are my battle. You are instrument in the hand of the Lord. It is God that inspired you to help that sister. It is God that inspired you to help that brother. When you came to the world, what have you got? Nothing. Naked you came. It is God that he started to harden you. He started to multiply. He started to increase you. So that you yourself, you can flow to others. And then you decided to become a mini God. You decided to take the glory of God. Tell your neighbor, humble yourself.
Humble yourself.
So that he will exalt you. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Today, we are instruments in the hand of the Lord. Amen. Why? Do you know why some people cannot make it? Because of pride. What do I say? Why some people can? It's because of pride. Because the Bible says he knows the enemy from the beginning. Say, in fact, anybody that is proud, do you know what God does? He put them away. First Peter, he says, he resists the proud. Don't come near me. I don't need you near me. And he gives grace to thee. Tell your neighbor, humble yourself. Under the mighty hand of God. So that he will exalt your heart. So that he will promote you. Hallelujah. Proverbs 16, verse 18. The Bible says, pride goeth before. Pride goeth before destruction. That is why some people, they cannot make it. Because God cannot, he cannot promote them. Because, you know, some people, even the way they walk, you will see that spirit in them. Some people, they bend. Because of pride, because of spirit of pride. I come against that spirit in your life in the name of Jesus. Proverbs 29 again. Proverbs 29, verse 23. Amen. Look at what Proverbs 29. Proverbs 29, verse 23. It says, a man's pride shall bring him. I'm telling you the reason why some people, they cannot make it in life. The Bible says, a man's pride shall bring him low. But honor shall uphold the humble in spirit. Honor will uphold you. I say honor will uphold you in the mighty name of Jesus. Proverbs 15, verse 25. Proverbs 15, verse 25. Listen to the scripture. Scripture says, the Lord will destroy the house of the Lord will destroy the house of the Lord will not destroy your house. Instead of them will not destroy your house. I am that I am will not destroy your house. He said, the Lord will destroy the house of the proud. When you go to Proverbs, he said, 16 dwell the Lord hate. Yes, 7 is an abomination. A proud root. A lying tongue. A thing that is quick to mischief. The thing that the Lord hates. Can we take one more? James 4, 6. He said, he resists the proud and gives grace to the humble. Hallelujah. Amen. Then the Bible says, he obeyed. That is the first thing he said. He humbled himself. The second thing, he obeyed unto death. Hallelujah. Samuel said to Saul, he said, to obey is better than. To obey is better than
sacrifice.
Talk to me, Bible scholar. To obey is better than
sacrifice.
Even to the cross. Do you know the cross became so heavy at the point for our Lord Jesus Christ in the Garden of Testimony? He said, Lord, if it is possible at all, take away this cup from me. He said, but not as I will. Let your will be done. Say, Father, let your will be done in my life. Pray. Say, Father, let your will be done in my life. Father, let your will be done in my life. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. It became obedient, even to the cross. And at the point, God sent angels to minister unto him. God will send angels to you in the name of Jesus. On Tuesday, we were doing digging deep. And then we came across this scripture. Isaiah 48, verse 18. He said, your peace will have been like rivers. Your peace will have been like if you hearken. If you are hearken unto me, if you have obeyed me. Do you see why some people don't have peace? Do you see why some people run elder and scatter? Because you don't obey. Obey what the Lord says. He said your peace will have been like rivers. I didn't mean you listen to me. I didn't mean you hearken unto me. I pray for the spirit of obedience over somebody today in the name of Jesus. You see, when you see the scripture, the promises of God, it has got some condition. And when we are there, thou shalt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed upon, his mind was stayed upon the Lord. That is why the Lord is going to grant him peace. This one said, if you have obeyed me, your peace will have been like river. I pray for the spirit of obedience for you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And there's reward of obedience. A songwriter said, trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. For you to be happy in Jesus, do you know it was when he humbled himself to death? That is where the Bible says, wherefore the Lord has highly exalted him and give him a name that is above every other name. That at the name of Jesus Christ, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. To the glory of God the Father. Hallelujah. There must be changes. What do I say? Say to your neighbor, there must be changes. In the way I talk, in the way I speak, in the way I conduct my life, even at home, even to my spouse, even to my co-workers, even to my neighbor, there must be transformation. There must be a change in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Because when you come the same way and go the same way, you know, we were talking about Garden of Fruitfulness. He said, building believer, fulfilling ministries. And somebody was giving testimony. I thank God for this parish that I was delighted when that fellow said, my Christian life has changed. That I can see my Christian life on the increase. I pray for every soul in this parish. You will be built. There will be transformation. The word of God will be imbued in you. In the name of Jesus, you will become a mighty instrument in the hand of the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. You must bear fruit. Because if you come and there's no transformation, there's no bearing of fruit. What fruit are we talking about? Bear the fruit of the Holy Spirit. What are the fruit of the Holy Spirit? Peace, love, gentleness, meekness. Against this, there's no law. Hallelujah. Galatians 5 verses 22 to 23. There must be transformation. Say to your neighbor, there must be transformation. There must be transformation. The mind of Christ must be in you. Hallelujah. Listen to me. Let us come to what the scripture says. Say this mind. You have got to propose in your heart that if you don't surrender to the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit will say this, no, it is my way. Listen to me. I'm going to give you this one, catch this one. They normally say some people, I was sharing with my wife, yeah, this one has got a mind of his or her own. I said, that's the lie of the devil. If you have got a mind of your own, you know what they are saying? You have got another mind, not the mind of Christ. When they say, that child, he's got a mind of his own. He's got a stubborn spirit. That is my own thing. He's got, when your mom says, sit down, you say, no, I don't want to sit down because you've got a mind. You've got another spirit in you. You've got another spirit in you. And let us call a spade. He says, he's got a mind. When you tell somebody to do something that person is not doing, he's got another spirit. And the other would take away that stony heart in the name of Jesus.
People will say, I got a mind of it. No! What the scripture teaches is that let this mind be in you, which was in Christ Jesus. Which mind are we talking? The mind of Jesus Christ. Was it not that thing that he said in Ezekiel 35 or 36? He said, I will take away a stony heart from you. I will give you a heart of flesh. That is what the scripture says. The scripture did not say, I will give you your whole mind. No. He said, I will take away stony heart from you. I will give you a heart of flesh. Jehovah will give us heart of flesh. I pray for heart of flesh. In the name of Jesus. If people have not noticed that something has changed in your life since you gave your life to Christ, then something is wrong. If your friend cannot say, my friend, I know you before you partner with Jesus Christ. If they cannot testify of that in you, you have to take stock of yourself. Then there's something wrong. Right now, if I say I've got a friend, they've abandoned me because we used to drink, fornicate, do all sorts of things. But they say, somebody said to me, this one, he has gone. I said, thank God that you know that I am gone. They said it, koro to my face, said, this one has gone, this one cannot come back. Yes! I got my man made up, and I won't turn back. Because I'll see my Jesus someday. I got my mind made up, and I won't turn back. Because I won't see my Jesus someday. I pray that somebody will make up his mind as well in the name of Jesus. Let me wrap it up. How can this one be achieved? How can this transformation be achieved? Number one, Zechariah 4:16. It is not by might or by power, but by the John chapter 15 verse 5. He said, without me you can do. You have to partner with Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. When you have to do what? Partner with Jesus Christ. For you to be transformed. It's not by mind, it's not by spirit, it's not by power, but by the Spirit of God. You have to partner with Jesus Christ. John 15:5. Hallelujah. Then the third one is by renewing your mind. What do I say? Again, Romans chapter 12, verse 1 and 2. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your body a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world. Let somebody say, be not conformed to this world. But be ye transformed by renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. When we are talking, how do you renew your mind? Through the word of God. What do I say? Ephesians chapter 6. He said, he will present the church unto himself. You know, by the watching of the word. It is the word. When you read, some of you are lazy. The moment you get from now, you leave your Bible. Until next Sunday, then you'll be looking. Where's my Bible? Where's my Bible? How can you renew your mind? Why would that spirit come over you? Do you know the moment you carry your Bible, another spirit come over you? The Spirit of Christ come over you. But when you don't open that Bible, it is another spirit that will be using you. When you cannot fast, you cannot pray, you cannot subdue that prayer. Jesus Christ said, this one could not except with fasting and prayer. This is how you can achieve transformation. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Ephesians 5, number 3, verse 18. He said, be not drunk with
wine.
Be not drunk with
wine.
But be filled
God, thank you, technical. Be filled with the Spirit. Speaking to yourself in psalms, in spiritual song. Singing and making. Some of you can't even sing praise. You, as you are watching play and you are singing, do you know power? Power and anointing is being released unto you. When you are watching that play and you are singing praises, and you are singing, do you know some people, even while they are watching play, they are praying in the Spirit, and they are singing. I've seen it before. And they are singing while they are watching. Then the Holy Spirit took over their mouth. They started to pray in the Spirit. That is how transformation, happen. But Jehovah will help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Our time is fast spent. I just want us to pray. Amen.
Let there be anointing. Holy Spirit, come and do what no man can do. Amen. King of God, come and do what no man can do. Lord, I pray for a divine touch, O Lord. I pray for a new heart, O Lord. I pray for a new spirit, O Lord. Let there be transformation, O Lord. I pray for mystery, O Lord. I pray for the Spirit of God, O Lord. Father, I come against stony heart, O Lord. Take away stony heart, O Lord. Release your meekness, O Lord. Release your goodness, O Lord. Release transformation, O Lord. Thank you, blessed Jehovah. Lord, as we go with us. Ancient of Heaven, go with us. I am the Lion, go with us. Daddy, prepare the way for us, O Lord. Let the angel go ahead of us. He shall be well with us. Thank you, blessed Jehovah. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We adore you, Father. Lord, I pray the blood of Jesus over every household, over every car. No accident in the name of Jesus. There shall be testimony in the name of Jesus. There shall be breakthrough in the name of Jesus. You will possess your possession. The Lord will increase your joy. Your anointing will not run dry in the name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Jehovah. For in Jesus' mighty name I pray. The grace in fellowship. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. The love of God. And the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit. Be with us now and forevermore. Amen. And surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Verily, 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 I say unto you, hallelujah. I say unto you, you shall be great, you shall be lifted, you shall be well with me. Again. Shall be well with you. Have a great and wonderful week in Jesus' name.
Discover Redeemed Christian Church of God, Garden of Fruitfulness, with Pastor Sanya, an anointed vessel of God.
Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. Lord, would you do? In this kingdom, you will not be far wanting.
Tell them, my dinner is ready. My salvation is ready.
Listen, if you don't have to think, you know how to give thanks.
Listen to this prophecy. It will come to pass.
Garden of prayer, you will be fruitful.
Yeah.
I said you will multiply.
Yeah.
I said you will increase.
Yeah.
You will work strong.
Yeah.
You will work great.
In the name of Jesus.
Join us every Sunday, 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. at Princess Margaret Road, East Tilbury, Essex. RM18 8SB. Tap into the anointing.